We're back. And boy, did we learn some mind-blowing facts about
fractals. Fractals!
Fractals. Some of us are taking it better than others. Treebeard, why are you so scared of fractals?
They have no beginning or end. They don't abide by the laws of geometry. They're the outlaws of shapes.
Well, can we tell our friends at home what a fractal even is?
Viewer discretion is advised.
In the late 1970s, a French mathematician named Benoit Mandelbrot noticed a disconnect between math and nature. Specifically, he realized that the classical rules of geometry didn't do a good job describing the shapes of nature. I mean, think about it. What shape is a pine cone?
Spinning.
What about a succulent?
Green.
What about a cactus?
It's out. Pokey.
We don't really have names for these kinds of shapes. Not like we do for man-made items. For example, a pencil is a hexagonal prism, or your laptop screen is a rectangle.
Or my beard is fuzzy.
Your beard isn't man-made, Treebeard.
You're right. It's the beard that makes the man. Bee? Don't leave me alone with the fractals!
Mandelbrot looked at snowflakes, leaves, shells, coastlines, and he realized that no matter the size or how the thing was formed, they all had one thing in common, which he called self-similarity. All fractals are self-similar, meaning that when you zoom in, it's the same repeating pattern. That's basically all a fractal is. A pattern that repeats itself across different scales.
Whoa. Wait, so what did Mandelbrot say about coastlines? Did he say I was right? Did he say it was 61 miles to westward?
Well, actually, coastlines are what gave Mandelbrot the idea of fractals. Mandelbrot wrote a paper titled, How Long is the Coastline of Britain? And he came to the conclusion that his question didn't actually make any sense. That's because coastlines have a fractal dimension. The more finely you measure them, the longer they become. That's why my measurement from Magruder to Westwind was so much longer than yours, Treebeard. You were running in straight long strides across the sand, while I was trying to run in all those little nooks and crannies. So no one won the bet.
So, who does Mandelbrot say won the bet?
No one won the bet, Treebeard.
But who won the bet? Who won the bet?